Hey there, I'm David Depasquale. I'm the lead character designer on the new Netflix animated movie, Arlo the Alligator Boy. And today, I'm gonna show you how to draw Arlo. Let's get started.
Frickety biscuit!
So we're gonna start with a circle. We have a vertical line, and a horizontal line. Then above that horizontal line, and kind of on either side of that vertical line, we're gonna draw two big ovals for his eyes. And two smaller ovals inside that for his pupils. And then for his nose, we're actually gonna draw four big bumps because alligators kind of have a bumpy nose. So I'll draw one that comes in between them, right? So one, two, three, four. And that fourth one's gonna be a little bit bigger because that's gonna be the front of his nose. And Arlo loves to sing, he loves to laugh. So he loves to make his friends smile. So we wanna give him a nice big smile here. So we're gonna go from the tip of this fourth bump here, and we're gonna kind of swoop in to give him this nice sort of big wide smile. We don't wanna go too straight, right? But we also don't wanna be too curvy. So we kind of want somewhere in between. So we're just gonna go like that. Right? It's gonna kind of end just behind his eyes. And we're gonna come down from there and give him this nice big open mouth. Great, now it's starting to look like something, huh? So we have the top of his jaw here, now we need the bottom of his jaw. So we're gonna go from the tip of his mouth to just inside that circle. He's gotta have a sense of smell, so let's give him his nostrils. Draw like two little thumb shapes on top of that fourth bump. And then inside, just two little upside down teardrop shapes for his nostril holes. From there, we're gonna give him his cheek. So his cheek comes over the top of his eye and also part of his mouth. So it's a half circle. Kind of comes out just like that. And then we're gonna give him his three freckles. So you have one, two, three freckles there. And we gotta give him his tongue. So his tongue, just a little rounded shape inside that bottom jaw. Then we gotta give him his teeth. Now, Arlo's an alligator, yeah, but he's not a bad alligator, so we don't wanna give him pointy teeth, right? We wanna give him nice soft teeth. So we're gonna draw one soft point underneath one nostril, one soft point under the other nostril, and then it kind of follows a pattern for the last two. So kind of a big and small under this second bump here. And then just under his eye, right in front of his cheek, you have big, small. Right, now we gotta draw his bottom teeth. So you have one, two in front, and one in front of his tongue. One to kind of match that on the other side. And then one just in front of these other teeth back here. And the other one's kind of covered by his tongue a little bit, so we probably won't be able to see it. We wanna shade in his tongue a little bit there, maybe. So let's go ahead and let's move on to his ear. And his ear, if you follow the first circle that you made, and that horizontal line, the ear's actually gonna be almost a complete circle just underneath that. So his ear's actually a little bit lower than you might think. And then we're gonna add an X in the middle, just for the inside. Awesome, getting somewhere. And then we're gonna move on to his sideburns. So his sideburns are these two little drop shapes, one short and one a little bit longer. And then we're gonna do the same for his bangs. So the same shape, right? This little drop shape we're gonna do on the side here for his bangs. So you have one, kind of connected to his sideburns here. You have one, you have two, and then there's a third one, but that third one's a little bit different because we like to think maybe he does his own hair. So we kind of chopped off the top of that one, which I think is really funny. Cool. And then we're gonna connect this top one back to the back of his head. So this big curved line, we're gonna connect it right to that circle that we made the first time. It's gonna kind of come right in between the sideburn here and the ear. So then you have the kind of top shape of his hair, and he's got a little cowlick back here. Again, he probably cut it himself. So we chop off, you know, that part of the hair, and then we're gonna do the same kind of shape here on the back of his head, just a little smaller. And then to connect, we do another little hair drop shape, and then another straight, kind of chopped off, bowl cut type line here. And his hair probably a little bit messy, so we like to give him a couple little cowlicks. We have one little free strands of hair. One up here, and two down here. Awesome. So we're almost done with his head. We just have to add a couple more details. So you have two chin lines here underneath his jaw. And then the bottom of his head actually just follows that initial circle that you made. And the same thing up here, you're going to connect his eye to his hair just by following that circle. We're going to give him eyebrows, which are just thin, tapered little lines. We're going to give him a little line underneath his eye. And then what we're going to do, we're not going to color his eyes in just yet. We're going to first give him little pie shapes so that we know which direction Arlo is looking in. Kind of helps. If you've ever seen old cartoons, they do that too, where they draw them little pies. I really like the way they look. Great. So there's Arlo's head. You did it. Now, let's move on to his body. So we're going to start at the bottom of his head here. We're going to draw two little swooshes for his neck. And then he's kind of got a bean-shaped, a little bit of a bean-shaped body. And we don't want to go too scrunched up in the back there, but it's kind of got this shape where, you know, kind of moves depending on what he's doing. So sometimes he's standing still, sometimes he's running forward, sometimes when he's playing his banjo, you know, he leans back a little bit. So his body can move, you know, in a bunch of different ways. So we're gonna sort of attach his neck to that little bean-shaped body. Awesome. And then we're gonna come just below center here, and we're gonna give him a little line for his pants. That way we know where his pants are gonna fall. And then we're gonna draw in his collar. So his collar is just a circle right around his neck, and then an M. So let's make an M right, kind of where his neck meets his body. And you just follow the line you just made, and then draw in the rest of the collar. So from the top of this beam, now we're gonna draw his shoulders and his arms. And his arms are kind of a little, they're tube-like, so they're kind of like two parallel lines, depending on what he's doing. You know, if he has his arms bent, you know, or his arms straight, they kind of follow each other. So we're going to draw his shoulders attaching to top of that shape there. Maybe he's got his hands on his hips. So we're going to draw his upper arm, his elbow, and his lower arm. And for his hand, it's just a circle. He's got these kind of pointy little fingers. Remember, he's part alligator, so we're going to do the same thing on the other side. These little tube arms. And a circle. His little pointy fingers. And then we want to indicate his t-shirt, so we're going to put his sleeves. Those are just going to follow the angle of his arms. Great. Now we want to draw his shoulder strap. So you start at his shoulder, kind of come down over his pants, because, you know, it's what holds his pants up. And then the other line comes from the inside of his collar and then goes down, wraps around his body. And then he draws little pant lines. He's got his front line and then his pocket line. His legs are very similar to his arms, so kind of these tubes that come out from that body shape. And at the end, he's kind of got these little reptile feet, so he's got these pointy toes. They're a little flatter than human feet. He's got three of them. And he has pant cuffs that kind of follow the shape of his legs, but come out just a little farther. So they look like long pants that have just been cuffed up to his knees. And then all we have to do is his tail. And his tail just kind of follows the curve of the bottom of his body, and then swoops up. And then just a curve for the top. And he's got these three bumps on his tail just like that. And then you've drawn Arlo. Good job.